this? Bad transmitter? If you can hear this, come on back to the hardware store. Got some news on the comm hub. Is this even broadcasting? Oh, wait. Maybe I just got it.
This has been a pre-recorded message. Message.
Thanks again for helping with the crate.
Not at all, my gentleman. But are you certain about the church?
Sure, why not? I mean, it's not like anyone else is using it.
Oh, may the Lord bless you for your kindness.
Trust me.
Okay,
the Lord,
then.
With all your heart.
Let me know if you need anything. Thanks.
Hey.
Howdy, darling. Good to see you again.
Who was that again?
Huh? Oh, you mean the fellow I was talking to. That's Edmund. Met him on the road from Olivia. Some kind of traveling preacher, I think. Nice guy. Helped me move the crate back here. He asked if I knew anywhere he could set up a church, so told him about the place across the road. Guess we're neighbors now.
How are you doing?
Gotta say, I'm doing pretty good. As you can see by the crate, I managed to get the comm hub back. Although it wasn't easy, let me tell you. I've got the hub inside if you'd like to see it.
I'll take a look, sure.
All right, follow me. There it is. Ain't she a beaut? Although sadly not ready for service just yet. In fact, I couldn't even turn it on. But I have been able to give the old gal a good going over. Got a rough understanding of the hardware.
Go ahead, I'm listening.
Well, judging by the internals, this thing mostly appears to be a giant processor. My guess is that it operates as a kind of ASAM switchboard, connecting and communicating with the sensors. Which makes sense, really. I mean, it is called the comm hub. Now, if we could get sensors connected and communicating, that really would open up our options. Let us do some cool things.
Oh, yeah? Like what?
Well, for example, remote management, mass software updates, division of settlement labor, and the obvious one, better communications. Now, to you, that last thing may not sound like much, but trust me, better communications is something we want. So I think it's in our best interest to get this comm hub running. Really begin to rebuild the Commonwealth.
I'm on board. When do we start?
In order to get things going, first, we need to turn this thing on. And for that, we're gonna need some serious power. And I'm afraid my little generator just ain't gonna cut it. However, as luck would have it, just a couple of feet below us is all the power we could need.
Go on.
Concord has a municipal plutonium well. Probably used to power every building in town. To get some real power flowing again, all you need to do is turn it on. That is, if you wouldn't mind helping out.
I'm on it. It's as good as done.
I knew you'd help. You'll have to discover a way into the old service tunnels running under Concord. Once you're down there, find something that looks like a big old generator. Do what you need to start it up, then head on back.
Yes. You should have all the power you need now.
Yeah, I noticed. When the power came back, it blew out half the bulbs in here. It's gonna be a pain in the ass to replace those. But the important thing is, we now have power.
So, the next step?
Next step is, we try turning on the comm hub. All right then, let's try powering this thing up. Now let's see here. Okay, connect this there. Move that. Let the bypass this. I think we're ready to give this a go. Best if you stand back. Okay. That didn't exactly go to plan.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. To be honest, I was kind of worried this might happen. The hub's been sitting around unused for so long, and so many of its parts have degraded. Seems even with enough power, there's no getting around blowing out capacitors and pair of semiconductors. Still, it's worth a try.
I'm sure we can work this out.
Give me a day or two. Maybe I could swap out some of the busted parts, clean a few tubes. It might be enough. I know it may not seem like it, but this was a step forward.
Don't worry. I haven't lost faith in you.
Thanks. I appreciate that. Oh, wait, before you go. Here, take this. After all the trouble we've had with raiders, I started wondering if ASAMS could offer a solution. Now, I've not had the time to put some together myself. Been too busy with the comm hub. But what you have there are instructions on how to jury-rig together a sort of defense plot. It's not very advanced, but should at least deter attacks from some of the small fry. Technically, it's just a creative use of an ASAM program with an industrial plot. But by making the changes listed on that piece of paper, the ASAM should be able to guide someone to build something a little more defensive. After that, it's just a matter of basic maintenance by whomever was assigned to it.
Sounds good.
I'm going to be busy with the comm hub for a while, so I won't have time to demonstrate. But I'm sure you'll be able to figure it out yourself. Thanks for your help today. I'll put out a radio message again when I've got news. Take care out there.
Blessed Father's light spoke through to the humbled man and said, "What would he say?" Oh, hello. My apologies. I seem to have lost track of where I was. I don't believe the two of us have formally met. My name is Edmund Callum.
This your chapel here, Pastor?
Yes, this chapel is mine in a sense, though it is open to all who would have need of it, including myself. Do you have need?
What did you say?
Ah, apologies. You stumbled upon me while I was reciting one of my sermons. Tell me, are you a religious sort?
It depends on the circumstances.
I see. A few of your sort have come through before. People who consider faith a last resort. I'll tell you now so you won't need to learn it later. It requires a bit more effort than that. We can discuss this another time, perhaps. I must return to my duties. But before I let you go, Jake says you're the one to go to when things need doing, so to speak.
I don't like running errands.
No, nothing like that. I just wanted to officially touch base, since you're the de facto leader around here, even if you may not like to admit it.
Okay, care to elaborate?
Well, you see, I've been walking the wasteland for a long time now. I've done my best to spread the gospel of the Blessed Father. I listen to the problems of the people, and I try to help as many as I can. It has earned me a number of grateful souls I consider to be my flock. I have heard more confessionals than you can imagine. I can tell you, I've seen a whole lot of places. There aren't too many you can find out there much safer than here. The efforts of you and the folks around is pretty darn unprecedented, to put it mildly.
Tell me about yourself.
Oh, my background is not important, my child. My story begins, as it does for so many, when I found the word of the Blessed Father. The man I was before just wasn't cutting it. Finding the Bible, spreading his message, it changed my life and the lives of countless others. The Lord made me an offer I could not refuse. Once it becomes known amongst my flock that I have found a safe church here in which to hold my sermons, many of them will most likely make their way here as well.
I'll keep an eye out.
Please do. It will be for the betterment of us all, Lord willing. One last thing. I was wondering if there was a place you all used to dispose of corpses? Oh, no. Like a graveyard. I didn't notice one around. When folks die of sickness and other things, they tend to come to the pastor if there's one around, at least from my experience.
What was that about people getting sick?
The wasteland is a harsh and dangerous place, my child. If it isn't raiders or super mutants, it's radiation and red scorpions. And with the limited medical supplies that may happen to be lying about, it's just as easy to get a disease from drinking water as it is from a mole rat bite. It's a good thing to think about these sorts of things, is all I'm saying.
Thanks. I always appreciate good advice.
And I always appreciate a chance to give it. You really should come by sometimes and catch a sermon or two. Even if you aren't a believer, I'm sure you will find something of use out of them. And if you don't mind me being a little selfish, it would be a great thing for my flock. Their courage will grow by wonders to see someone out there making a difference, one way or the other. And perhaps you can lend a helping hand or two as well. It won't go unnoticed. I will keep you no longer. Go free, my child.
Thanks, Pastor.
Excuse me, you there. Might I trouble you for a moment of your time?
Of course. What's up?
Now, I hate to ask a stranger for this, but I need a bit of a hand tracking down a few of my workers. You see now, me and my caravan moseyed on into the area a few days back now. Come up from Virginia in the wreckage of the late Great Virginia Caravan Company. But the death of my hard work, hopes, and the very foundation of myself as a man is neither here nor there. Right now, there's other things to worry about. Unfortunate to say, but most of my people didn't make it down the road. Bobby over here is the only one besides myself yet unmaimed by the Commonwealth. I know at least two of my folks made it into the local area, but we got separated before Concord. If you could find them for me, I'd be mighty grateful.
Don't worry. I can help. Tell me what happened.
Well, I thank you kindly. Not a lot of folks willing to help others out in these times. I won't forget this. Look, there's two of them. The first one got grabbed by a group of raiders near some big stone fortress we passed by. You'll probably need to crack a few heads to get him back. The second one got lost up by Natick. Old world town. Place is overrun with undesirables. If you can find them alive, then just tell them to meet me here in Concord. If you find them dead, I'd like you to bring me something back. Something I might be able to send their family later down the road.
All right. I'll find them.
I can't thank you enough, stranger. And I won't forget this.
So what's your story? Looking to trade? Rob me? Or just ask directions to Diamond City?
Just looking for love, sweetheart.
Girl, have you come to the wrong place? I'll tell you what, Bu.
I'll take a look, sure.
I got a little bit of it.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Thank you.
Nice.
Finders keepers, am I right?
That's it.
Thank you.
Hey there.
If you got a minute, would you mind checking on my old buddy Amos? He lives in a shack not far from here, and I haven't heard from him in a spell. I'm starting to worry if something's happened to the old coot.
Sure thing.
Much obliged. Here's where you can find him.
Kidding me?
Playing games with me, huh?
Good dog. Nuka-Cola. Interesting name. All right, let's go. Thank you.
back already? How's the old boozer faring these days? And who's the little lady? Gracious, she looks in a bad way.
I'm sorry. He's dead.
Dang. I kept telling him those raiders were camped too close for comfort. Well, let's have a look at our little lady here. Easy there, little lady. Easy, girl. Gracious, what did they do to you? I know you've got other things to worry about. She's hurt pretty bad, but I can help her through this. Please, leave her with me. Before you go, though, if you happen to have or find some dog food or fresh meat, I know little Cola here would appreciate it.
Hi.
I'm running low on food for little Cola. Could really use anything you have to spare.
Sure. Here you go.
Oh, much obliged, much obliged. This'll do nicely. Say thank you, little Cola.